You'll be given a new identity.
Oh.
Ciao, bella. Hey, come esta?
The confidence builder.
You're gonna ruin this mission.
What are you doing?
I'm saving you.
What a fun film.
It's a doozy. It's pretty doozy, fun, right?
Yeah. So when Paul came to you with this idea of sort of a spy film, and you're end up being the main spy,
yes.
What did you think?
You know what? He actually had just finished writing it, and my husband Ben and I were at his house, and he, you know, I said, well, you just finished, what's it about? And he said a few things about it, and then someone else started talking about something else, and I was like, and then what? And then what? And then what? And Ben was like, do you want him to, what do you want him to read you the whole script? Because I kept interrupting people. I was like, then what does she do? And she's out of the base. I could not get off of it. I could not stop asking him questions.
Susan.
Hey, Patrick.
Yes.
I was given specific instructions by Elaine to tailor these gadgets to you. These are not yours. This antifungal spray can freeze and disable any security system.
Wow. That is quite an image to be carrying all over Europe.
It's also a pepper spray.
Why not just make it look like pepper spray?
It's a pretty good idea. All right, well, next time.
Because I love this whole sort of turn of being someone that you don't think is capable and ends up being probably the most capable one in the room.
Yeah. Which is, that was a big part of what I loved, that she's undervalued, underestimated, and really doesn't have a lot of self-confidence in herself. Has all the ability, and yet doesn't want to be showy. Always is willing to take the back seat.
Which is a thing a lot of women do,
right? I think a ton of women do that.
Yeah.
I think we've all done that at some point.
Yeah.
And then I loved watching her for all the right reasons, especially to really go back and try to right a wrong for someone she's loved, and do the right thing and really take her position serious. I love that she went. I mean, to have a character in one movie that starts here and ends up here is, you do not come across that every day.
Now we have to talk about our Aussie Rose Byrne, because this is what, the second time now you've played with Rose? And she's so funny.
She was this
dramatic actress, and now look what's happened to her.
I know. She's wildly funny.
Yeah.
I mean, she's a crazy, crazy funny woman.
Yeah.
That just happens to be able to do anything. She's great. And Rose and Rose's hair.
Yes, Rose's hair was quite a thing, right?
I mean, there were just, every day I would just wait for it. And when she'd come around the corner, I was like, ooh, that's even better and bigger.
You're funny. It's the Bulgarian clown in you.
Okay.
She was marvelous, but she was different. Eccentric, like you are.
No.
The moment I saw you standing there in that abortion of a dress, it's as if to say, this is what I've got, world. It's hideous, but it's mine.
I mean, does it feel like Hollywood is really seeing you as a comedy star now?
I hope so. I'll take it. Yeah, Paul was, you know, he's such a... Paul Feig, the director, writer-director, he's a real delight to work with. I've been so lucky to have this opportunity again. And he's so collaborative, you know, when we first started talking about it, and it's very much... throw all the ideas in, let's figure it out, we rehearse, and he's really aesthetic, you know, he's a true eccentric, he wears a three-piece suit to work every day, he has a cane, he doesn't need a cane, he has a cane, top hat, and so something like this genre, he was just so enjoying the visual aesthetic of the whole thing, because it really is about style, it's one of a spy genre. So.
You play Raina?
Yes.
And how would you describe her?
I describe her as rather duplicitous, mysterious woman who comes into Susan's life. Well, you really know what her deal is. She's a, you know, with the bad guys, she's a nuclear arms dealer, she's Bulgarian, and she's a lot of fun. Yeah, it was a lot of fun, really fun to play her. Hard to keep a straight face with Melissa.
I bet.
She's just, you know, oh my God, it's game on with her, because, you know, we do a lot of improv, and she can just go on these bits that are like, so spontaneous and bizarre.
Your improv skills must be getting like really good now. Yeah,
well, you know, they have writers on set too. Yeah. You know, obviously Paul is there, who are pitching ideas. Mm. So you're getting like little alts a lot of the time to, you know, try stuff out. And yeah, I have my attempts as well. I've gotten more confident. This is the fourth film I've done where improv is a really improv-based set.
Yeah.
So, but you always start from the script, which is already very funny, and the characters. You know, he just creates such great characters, Paul. They're very, particularly for women.
Yeah.
He's such a champion of women. You know, traditionally my part in this film would have been a guy, and, you know, he really turns that convention on its head. So I just admire him so much.
I am so
Phenomenal job.
Bye.